Today we will see NP on assessment and evaluation. What is the modality of assessment and evaluation is proposed by NP 2020. We know that the NP 2020 has come up with a long deliberation. If you don't know, then we will have a very brief discussion about how the NP 2020 is formed. This government has started formulating new education policy, that is a national. It is very important to remember that in the so many platform it is termed as a new education policy, but in fact the name is the national education policy. Okay, and so many long deliberations has been done for framing this new education policy. Have you seen the new education policy, or shall I show you?
Yes sir.
Okay, if you have seen, then it's well and good. And before the framing this new education policy, the comments, the recommendations, feelings of all the stakeholder has been collected throughout the country, right from the top level institutions, those who are working in the field of school education, management of school education, like NEPA, like NCERT, even up to the gram panchayats, teachers, teacher educators, their opinion has been taken. And on the basis of their opinions, on the basis of the research evidences, the new education policy, National Education Policy 2020, is framed. So that is come up with us with a rigorous process. The process was rigorous. So many consultation meeting, and so many the top level consultation were done before framing this national education policy. And when you will see the national education policy, one of the very important aspect of this national education policy is the provision of continuous review. Okay, so it says that at a regular interval and at a regular time, the review of the policy will be done, and on the basis of the review, as and when it is required, it can be revised. So that is the one of the important aspect. And when we talk about the assessment of students' learning, it emphasizes one of the very burning issue in the today's scenario in the field of school education, even in the higher education, that is the presence of coaching culture. It says that the focus of regular formative assessment for learning should be there rather than a summative assessment that encourages the coaching culture. Because we know that in order to excel in the examination, so many coaching institutes are established, which used to prepare the student for the summative assessment. And this type of a coaching culture comes because student have a pressure to excel in the summative assessment, because summative assessment is done at the end of the academic time. It may be annual or it may be the semester one. Okay, so this says that there should be a provision of assessment of learning, assessment for learning, and assessment as learning. These three component must be included when we talk assessment of the learning. Okay, so this is the thing which is highlighted in the new education policy. The second thing is said that there should be a focus on the continuous assessment rather than the focus on the summative assessment. The point of saying is that even we know that in the previous policy, it was also highlighted that there should be focus on continuous and comprehensive evaluation. This policy also outlines that this philosophy should be continued. The reason is very clear that this policy wants to de-emphasize the coaching culture and deprioritize the summative assessment, which promotes the rote learning. And when we talk about the other thing on the curricular side, it says that there will be an increased focus on the fundamental literacy and numeracy and the general reading, writing, speaking, counting, arithmetic and mathematical thinking skills. And this will be included in the preparatory and the middle school curriculum. Because when we talk about the educational framework of framework that is proposed by this curriculum policy, it says that it will be 5+3+3+4, where this 5 includes 2 years of a preparatory stage and 3 years of a primary stage of a learning. When we see the age of a student in this stage, we find that at this stage, student must be developed their vocabulary, their basic arithmetic and the counting skill, then the speaking, reading and writing. Because this stage is thought that this will prepare the student for the future learning, isn't it? So this is the right time to develop this type of basic skills in the learners. Then at the higher stage, like grade 6 to 8, it says that now the student should be involved in participating project activity and the higher order thinking processing skills. Okay, so at this stage, the various subjects like science, social science, language must be included. But the form of assessment, but the tool, assessment as a tool, will be the assessment as of and for learning. Means assessment for learning, the teacher will try to understand what is the need of the child, what is the requirement of a child to identify their strength and also to identify the steps to be taken by the teacher for the betterment of a student. So this is the broad framework of NEP 2020. Then specifically when we come to the assessment and evaluation, because so many time I was saying that previous policy, we are not able to achieve their aims and objectives. The one of the reason identified was that there was a lack of action plans that how it will be implemented, and that is taken by this policy. So the overall objective of this policy is to promote understanding about the concept, to deprioritize coaching culture, to deprioritize rote learning, and to prioritize the formative assessment, continuous assessment, rather than the summative assessment. So in order to implement all those things, there are some recommendations. The first recommendation is that the aim of assessment must be the culture, in the culture of the schooling system, and it must shift from that one which is a summative and primarily test the rote memorization to the more regular and formative, and it must be competency based, promotes learning and develops the student's thinking process, and it must be focused on the testing of higher order processing skills such as analysis, critical thinking, conceptual clarity, like that. So here they try to focus that the assessment and evaluation must shift from the summative one to the formative one, which will decrease the rote memorization of the concept, and it will develop the higher order thinking process. It will be competency based. One of the very important point here which is highlighted is the competency based assessment. So here it will be not the motto of assessment and evaluation, that to what extent the students are able to remember the content, rather than the competency in the content which is taught. Suppose that when we talk about the mathematics, so the competency may be the competency of drawing skills, competency of labeling skill, competency in the solving problem, like that. There will be a different labels of a competency, and that will be assessed when we will talking about the assessment of evaluation, assessment of learning, isn't it? The second thing which is highlighted, that how it will be transacted, this is that the progress card of a student will be some, the it will have a some part as a school based assessment, which will communicated by the school to the parents. And what will be the framework of having a school based assessment, that will be decided by National Assessment Center SCRT in the state, and at a national level NCERT, and it will be holistic in nature with 360 degree multidimensional report card that will reflect the detailed progress of a student. The point of saying is that rather than having a one-shot examination like a formative one, there will be a summative assessment, and it will be school-based assessment. That is one of the another thing which is highlighted. School-based assessment means there will be no involvement of external agency in the assessment and evaluation process. Assessment will be truly and purely done at a school level, which will cover both scholastic and co-scholastic areas. That's why it is saying the 360 multidimensional report card means it will include all the dimension of a student's learning and a progress in the report card. It will not only include the curricular part, rather than it will also include the co-curricular part. It will also include their competency, the child's competency in the game, sport, cultural activity, and all the things, so that we can understand the holistic development of a child. When you see this policy, it talks about the holistic development of a child rather than the skewed development only in the curricular areas. Okay, so that is one of the another emphasis which is given. But it was also seen that you will find in the earlier policy, and even in the so many report, we already know that the school-based assessment is emphasized and the holistic assessment procedure is emphasized. Then how this policy is different? Because here there will be a framework, well-defined framework. In the earlier policies and in the earlier reports also, they were talking about that, but in the absence of a framed structure of school-based assessment, it could not be implemented in its true spirit. So they says that the responsibility of development of a modality will be given to the NCERT at a national level and the National Assessment Center together with the SCERT at a state level, because we know that education comes under the concurrent list, and there is a reason also because the India is a so much a diversified country in terms of various variables. So that's why the role will be given to them and they will be developing the modality of assessment, how the school based assessment should be done. And here there will be a lot of work like that. It will include the all dimension of learning, like that the cognitive, affective and a psychomotor domain. All the domain of a learning will be included. So it will be not like that. Even when we talk about the summative assessment, I think in the previous class also you were talking that the motto of a summative assessment and the motto of a CCE was to picturize the holistic development of a child over the time period. But somehow the modality that we have, it is not able to reach to that level, because there was some problem in the transactional process. Here it will be well structured by keeping in the mind the cognitive part, affective part and the psychomotor domain. So the all the domain will be covered when it will come to assessment and evaluation of students' learning. For the cognitive part, there may be some exam, it may be the observation, it may be the portfolio maintenance, it may be the verbal testing, like that. And for the affective domain, there may be a observation, maintaining a portfolio, that is the alternate mode of assessment that we know. So these type of techniques will be implemented, that will be used. Even for the psychomotor domain, we may have a practical session. I was saying that all the domain of learning will be assessed, and even they emphasize the modality of assessment. They say that it may include the self-assessment, peer assessment and a progress of a child in a project-based and inquiry-based learning. Okay, so many modalities of assessment will be included, that will be as a part of assessment and evaluation process. Even it says that for the cognitive domain, quizzes may be there, which is not a very conventional method of assessment. Quizzes we are not very frequently using for the assessment and evaluation purpose. Even the role play, so that the affective part of assessment and a psychomotor domain part of assessment, part of a learning can be assessed. Even the group work, portfolio assessment, and apart from that, teacher implemented assessment, like that the teacher is doing paper pencil test or the verbal testing, like that, or the problem solving, this that which is done by the teacher, that will be also a part. But together with that, the variety of a method of assessment will be included in the assessment and evaluation process, which will shift the learning from rote learning of a content, memorizing the content, to which is meaningful and which is based upon understanding of the concept. And obviously, when the learning will shift from memorization, rote learning, to which is the learning based upon the understanding the concept, then obviously the coaching culture and the summative assessment will be deprioritized. So that is a necessity, because we have seen over the time period coaching culture has harmed the education process to a large extent. because students have a pressure of securing, fetching more marks. Okay, so that is the one of the very important thing which is emphasized in the national policy on education. Then when we talk about the other modality of assessment which is emphasized here, they also says that sometime to keep tracking on the student's learning, the artificial intelligence based software can also be developed and can also be used to help to by the teacher to track the student's progress and a growth over the time period. So this policy are very progressive in nature when it comes the assessment and evaluation of the student's learning. It have a provision of implementing a variety of strategy for the teaching learning purpose. Not only that conventional paper pencil test, that will be also a part, but together with the portfolio assessment, peer assessment, group assessment, self assessment, even the use of artificial intelligence technology will also be there. Then the next thing is that which says that the current nature of a secondary school examination, the board examination and the other trans examination promotes the coaching culture which are harming the educational system to a large extent. So even for that they used to say that in the board examination, that the secondary school examination and in the entrance examination also, there will be some flexibility in the assessment. Okay, so it will be not the assessment will be taken at a single shot, or it will be not a compulsion of a subject. It will be not a compulsion of assessing the students at a single examination, but there will be a flexibility and a choice that will be the also one of the important aspect. But how this flexibility, how the choice and all those things will be done, that will be, I think they will frame when this policy will be implemented. This policy was supposed to be implemented by 22-23, but I think due to the pandemic situation in the country, it won't be implemented. But the modality of making board examination flexible, that will be worked out, that how it can be implemented. Okay, then the next thing which is again very important part here is that the board examinations of class 10 and 12 will be continued. So that will be not scrapped. The board examination will be there. Existing board examination and entrance examination will be there. But it will be reformed to eliminate the need of undertaking coaching classes. That is very clearly it is outlined. I am reading the exact sentence for you. While the board exam for grade 10 and 12 will be continued, the existing system of board and entrance examination shall be reformed to eliminate the need for undertaking coaching classes. So the modality, I think they will frame later on, that what will be the modality of eliminating the board the coaching culture from the board examination and entrance examination, that they will talk. But a clear indication they have given that in the board examinations also there will be a component of a higher order thinking skill, and there will be some weightage from the school based assessment, so that the coaching culture can be eliminated and the school-based assessment can be emphasized. Even they also talk that in addition to the other thing that they have talked, there will be a greater flexibility, student choice, and the best of two attempt assessment, that is primarily a test core capacities, must be immediate key reform to all board examination. So the modality may be that in the name of a flexibility, there may be opportunity of more than one attempt, and the best attempt will be the part of a board examination mark. So that is also one of the thing which is emphasized. Even this is that the modality of conducting board examination shall be prepared by the NCERT at a national level and by SCERT and Board of Assessment at a state level, isn't it? And they also says that in the board examination, a variety of questions will be there. The question will be not only from the long answer, or the question will be not only based upon the memory based, rather than the variety of a question will be there. There will be a question based upon the higher order thinking, problem solving like that, and the variety of question in from the nature of a question perspective, like a short answer type of a question, multiple choice type of a question, matching type of a question. So many, the variety of questions will be given so that it will suit to the majority of students. Then the next one, they say that to track the progress throughout the school years, not just at the end of grade 10 and 12, the assessment will be there, but for the benefit of a student, parent, teacher, principal, and the entire schooling system, planning of improvement of school-based assessment and a teaching learning process will be there. And from there, it indicates that the earlier no detention policy will be scrapped out, because they say that the progress will be tracked. And very clearly they also says that at the grade 3rd, grade 5 and grade 8, the exam will be conducted by the appropriate authority. Appropriate authority will be the school board of the concerned state, and at a national level it may be CBSE, or they have also talked about that national testing agency kind of organization will be framed. So, apart from that, when we were talking about the no detention policy, we are knowing that till the completion of elementary level, there will be no examination. So, like that, only the examination at the end of a 10th and at the end of a 12th will be there. But this says that the examination will be also at when the student will complete grade 3, grade 5 and grade 8. Okay, and these examination will test the assessment of basic learning outcome through the assessment of a core concepts and the knowledge from the national and local curricula, rather than which is based upon the rote memorization. So it will be very practical based examination. For that you are not supposed to remember the content which is given in the syllabus in the textbook. It will be very contextual, and it will be assessing the real life experience of the child. And apart from that, the grade 3rd examination in particularly, as previously I was also saying, that grade 3rd examination in particularly, it will be the testing of basic literacy, numeracy and other fundamental skills like the reading, writing, calculating, like that thing. Okay, and the result of school examination will be used for the developmental purpose of the school education, including the public disclosure by the school of their overall students' performance. That how their students are performing. So that when we talk in this line, we can understand that school will be made more accountable. Their accountability will be outlined because they are supposed to release the student's performance. It is not like that the performance of individual student, but the average performance. Okay, so that we can understand how the school is performing and how the children's of students are performing. It also, because it says that formulation of so many things for the assessment and evaluation purpose. So that's why it outlines the setting up of National Assessment Center, which will known as a PARAC, Performance Assessment Review and Analysis of Knowledge for Holistic Development. So PARAC Center, which is a which will be a National Assessment Center, will be set up. And the function of this PARAC will be to outline the standard, setting norms and guidelines for the assessment and evaluation of students. And this will also act as a guiding agency for the state boards of assessment, because state board of assessment are also supposed to work in line with the national education policy. And apart from that, there will be a national achievement survey. Okay, that will try to outline the overall achievement of the student in the school throughout the country. What is the label of achievement of the student in the country? Nowadays also we used to have a national achievement survey, which says, and that is the survey conducted by now the NCERT. The similar kind of survey is also conducted by the Pratham, which is known as ASAR survey, which is known as the ASAR. Pratham is an NGO which conducts the ASAR survey. You can find the report of ASAR survey in the internet. I think you must have heard some point of our from the news or some other platform that a student of class 5 is not able to solve the mathematics problem of class 2 or 3. So this type of the finding that you are getting from the different news media, that is the finding of a ASAR survey which is conducted by the Pratham. But parallelly, the NCERT is also conducting, which is known as a National Assessment Survey, National Achievement Survey, which try to outline that what is the overall performance of the student in the country in a different grade. And based upon their performance, they used to frame the policy. They used to take the policy level decisions. Okay, so that was the overall brief outline of the National Education Policy 2020 on the education and the assessment and evaluation of students at school level.